Hey there guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman and today we are going to create another mobile game. By the way, I ended up reinstalling Windows 10. Wah wah wah. Apparently you need Windows 10. I think what slows it down the most is Windows Defender. So I disabled that. No more Windows Defender. Every time you restart your computer, Windows Defender comes back.
Anyways, that's besides the point.
Okay, so let me show you the demo. Here it is. Whoa, it doesn't look like much. Okay, because it doesn't have any graphics yet. Well, it does, but they're not very good. Okay, so the point of the game is to tap on the screen and avoid the spikes. Okay, everyone should avoid spikes.
No!
Okay, I didn't make it too far that time. That was bad. Okay, 16, 17, that's not too bad. Wow, I almost crashed into the spike that time.
No!
Wow, I cannot even make it to 40. I got 16 so far.
17, 19, 20, 21, 23, 24.
I can make it to 40. Yes, I can.
No!
Where's my double jump? Let's open the example file, which is under the description below. Now, if you don't have the software, download it. There's a link down below. Okay, so let's get started. Let's go over the assets very quickly. And there's not much here to look at. It's the block. Okay. And here we have some amazing pixelated spikes. Now, these objects are bouncing balls. These are the initial directions. Now, not to worry about the speed, because this counter here, it equals the speed of the bouncing balls. Now, these are just pillars made of pixels. And that's it. I'm using two counters. And I'm using this counter here and this one over here. Okay, let's go to the event editor. And I guess at the start of the frame, we could set up our object, which is going to be the block. Okay, try it out. That works fine. If it collides with another object, which is going to be the ground, this object here, I'm going to test for obstacle overlap. This goes first, otherwise it doesn't work. If that happens, we go to collisions and we make them stop. And that works not too bad. Now, this is meant for mobile games, so you are only going to be able to tap on the screen or click on the screen. So we have this counter here, which is just called counter. It's right here. So if this counter is set to zero, then under user input, user is holding the right key. Right out. You can see that our object moves on its own. Copy and paste this. Counter equals one. Then under user input, user is holding the left key. So we got a green pillar and a red pillar. Test for obstacle overlap again. And if the block collides with the green pillar, then we set the counter to one. Try it out. That works fine. Let's do the opposite for the other side, the red pillar. So if that happens, we're going to set the counter back to zero. That works fine. Waiting for the zero. And that works fine. Now we just need to make our object jump. So if the user taps on the screen or clicks on the screen, same thing. Then we make our object jump. Right out. Wow, so easy. So if the spikes leave the play area, this position, left or right, I set that backwards again. Then we're gonna go to movement and we're gonna wrap around the play area. Wow, that looks very difficult. If we had any collisions, if our character collides with one of the spikes, test for obstacle overlap. Goes first, then we're gonna restart the frame. But you can make it whatever you want. You can play a dying animation or something like that. That works fine. Now the spikes are moving a little too fast, so I'm going to create an always. Now we have this counter here, which I should have labeled, but I didn't. We're gonna set the speed of the spikes equals the counter. try it out. They start very slow because the counter is set to 10 by default. So every second, we want to add one to this counter. Try it out. Whoa, is it me or the spikes are getting faster? They are getting faster. How is this even possible? But if you notice that I can sort of like fly if I wanted to. Alright, so we're going to fix that. Luckily for us, we have another counter here, which is red for some reason. So if we collide with the floor, we're going to set this counter to 0. And on the line 7, this counter needs to be less than 2. Lower than 2. In order for this to work. When this happens, we're going to add 1 to this counter. So that way we have double jump. We can only double jump once. Counter's out of the way. I'm gonna make a new counter, clone this, and this will be the score. Initial value 0, maximum a lot. So every second we can add 1 to that counter. And that's our score. Whoa, I have 2 points now. Not too bad. You can probably replace this block for something like a bird, a dog, cat, a penguin, an elephant, something. Oh, darn it. You can see that making mobile games in Fusion, it's extremely simple. If you liked this video, hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first and top comment.
Hola a todos, les habla Papyrus el Esqueleto, y hoy quería hablar sobre algo.
Alright, so thanks for watching. Don't forget the competition ends in a couple of days. And ClickTeam was kind enough to offer a prize. The winner of the competition will win a copy of ClickTeam Fusion 2.5. And if you already own ClickTeam Fusion, you will win a super discount for the plugin. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.